Namaste and welcome to Planet to Soul Astrology. So friends, you can see on the screen who is sitting in front of me. So I need not give special introduction of him because each and every one of you know him. I give him the name of Nakshatra Master or Master of Nakshatras because the one who dedicatedly do the research in anything, and he is doing research in nakshatra, so definitely I can call him a master blaster of nakshatra. And let us all welcome Dr. Arjun Pai on our channel, and we will discuss today. I asked him what topic, so we were just deciding what topic to be talk about. So today we will talk about Mahadasha and Nakshatra. So how we can use Nakshatras in Mahadasha, whatever we are running. So over to you.
Namaste. Namaste to everybody and namaste Sunilee ji. Such a honor to come on your channel, you know, Soul to Planet. It's a grace, I would say. And you know, you've given me so much of praise. Thank you. I'm just a student. I'm a researcher, I'm not a master. There is so much more to learn. Even if you start with nakshatras, you know, it will never end. Even in this lifetime, I think there is so much of information that we do not know. What we know is very little. We know only very little information. And I've been researching on nakshatras for a few years now. Yes, indeed. But I say that, you know, this is a never-ending journey. You know?
Yeah, actually what I say always, that we are the Mula Nakshatra, each and every human being. Correct. Because we are roots, we don't know.
Correct.
Only we can see the tree. I always consider this way. Because we are not yet able to go inside the roots. So we all are Mula Nakshatra, we all are Ketus.
Correct. You know, this is very interesting that, you know, you said let's do something on the Dasha system.
Yeah.
Okay. Lately I've been researching. And I want to share some of my own insights with everybody on your channel. And people can freely test this and see, you know, if it works, give us the feedback so that we will be able to enhance and learn from this. Now, I don't know, Sunilee ji, where to start from, but what I want to say is, even to talk about nakshatras, you know, I will talk very basic about nakshatras before we go into the dasha system that people can use. And there are many techniques out there. Many people have come up with many techniques. This is one of those techniques. This is not the only technique, you know, that I want to say. But firstly, you know, you need to know the nakshatra-based system is very ancient for us. It's a very indigenous system for the Indians as well. And predominantly, I feel that we had studied this system also from the Persians, because the Persians were very much into, you know, even if you see this, most of the stars today in this system, they are still named after Persian names. And they used to call it manzil, you know, you can say manzil. Manzil means, in Persian, means mansion.
Yeah.
Manzil for the moon. So whenever the moon transits,
Achha.
So it's called lunar mansions. Then the English version became lunar mansions.
Achha.
Okay, the Persians used to call it manzil, which means it's a house which is tenanted by the moon.
Yeah, here we call it as a floor, manzil.
Mm. Yes. Okay. So some floor, each floor, you can think there are 27 floors if you want to think like that.
Yeah.
Each manzil is when he just starts. And most of the names still have been very much in Persian.
Mm-hmm.
So this, and why Persia is because mostly it was, you know, it was desert there. And I feel they had clear skies and they had the opportunity to watch the sky and look at the events that were happening.
Okay.
So we were greatly influenced by them. And at the same time, we have also taught them many of our techniques as well. So that was a huge exchange of information. My sense is that must have happened during the Vedic times. But if you say very deeply, the Vedic scriptures have all been maintained for, you know, thousands of years. I don't want to go into the dating of things because people can do their own research and find out.
And there can be debate on it.
Yes, there can be a debate, which I don't want to get into. That's not the purpose. The purpose is not saying who is older and what is the system older, but we have to appreciate that all civilizations have their own system, and that, as you know, it works as well. And recently, when I was in Sedona, I met with a Persian astrologer called Hassan Kezini.
Yes.
And he had some very great insights on especially fixed stars and things like that. So there is more research which needs to be done there from a Persian perspective. But from the Indian perspective, where I want people to focus more on, and that's my next research which I'm going to do this year, and I'm going to share this freely with everybody, is what you need to know is many of the temples, and especially in the southern part of India, they were all based on nakshatras, and there was a horoscope which was casted, and the temples were built and consecrated as per like a living being. So there were three things that were very important, which is a lost information, and I feel that more people can connect to it through this discussion, and people will do find some great insights with these temples. Is firstly the deity which is sitting inside the temple. Okay, you can connect it with the sun, and the female deity, and the in the southern part of it. Sunilee Ji, are you there?
Yeah, I'm there. This connection was unstable, but you continue. Now it's stable.
Okay. So there was a vriksha, which is a tree also associated with each temple. Okay, so these are the three things that are themes which will actually, if you go deeper into understanding these temples and the mythology, every temple in the south has a mythology associated with it, and there is the deity who is sitting inside has a mythology, and the myths can actually identify what nakshatras are activated in when you go into those temples. This is a secret thing that all our ancients knew. If you go to Tamil Nadu, and most of the temples around Tamil Nadu, Kerala, you know, Andhra Pradesh, and Karnataka, the southern parts, even Maharashtra, many of the temples were, and Tamil Nadu were especially built based on horoscopy only. So the temples have a life. They have, they're like a living being. There is a life in them, and when you go there, certain vibrations of certain nakshatras will attune you to get you better results. Anyway, that is
okay. Ask you that, are you aware of any nakshatra temples?
I have heard of so many nakshatra temples in the southern part near Kanchipuram. There are many.
Okay.
Okay. What is not Kanchipuram? Is it called Kumbakonam, I think. Around Kumbakonam, there are many nakshatra.
That is middle of southern side.
Yeah, southern side. Somewhere. Okay. I have not been to any of them, but my people I've associated with, you know, some peers, some colleagues, some students who have been there, they have said that these nakshatra temples are in such bad situation. There is nobody to take care of them. They have, you know, their things are falling apart, and things, they're really trying to revive these temples, but there is no funds which are coming. But anyway, my topic is not to talk about that, but
yeah, this is very interesting.
But I wanted to bring this up because, you know, it's very unfortunate. Our ancient had built certain vortexes. Okay, and the basis of these vortexes were based on the principles that we know in what we have learned is, you know, one of the things that I have to say that the three principles, or what we say is the problematic areas that we face in our life. You know, they can be connected to three forms. I'm just trying to see. Yeah. So the three forms which are maintained in the scriptures over and over again, because of which we suffer. There are three types of sufferings the scriptures talk about. And we have called them tapatraya.
Mm-hmm.
You know what is tapatraya? Tapatraya means miseries. There are three types of miseries. Tapa, traya. Traya means three. And they can be categorized into adhyatmika, adhidaivika, and adhibhautika. I hope you know these things, Sunilee.
I have heard of that. Tap means tuckling, means miseries, troubles.
Miseries, yes. Traya means three. There are three types of miseries that human beings go through. So, tapatraya, okay? So, tapa also means sometimes, you know, the sacrifices that you do. So, they are categorized into three parts, which is adhyatmika, adhidaivika, and adhibhautika. Adhibhautika literally means pertaining to the bhutas or the living beings. Or it is those sort of fears. See, firstly, I want to say to your viewers, they have to know that we are all mostly karmic beings.
Yeah.
Or we are, when you say we are all karmic beings, then we have a soul which is defined as a karmic being, and we have only known that these have certain human personalities which marks it. But actually, if I have to say to you, and this is the genesis of the nakshatras as well, is we have a certain karmic code. So the soul's karmic code is based on the life patterns that we have created through our habits, through our tendencies, through influences, through our desires that we have set into motion from many life births. Just like we have a genetic code, which we call it as a DNA for the body. Similarly, for the soul, there is something called as, you know, karmic code. Now, in our Sanskrit thing, we call these as, we are carrying these karmic propensities, which we call it samskaras. And these samskaras are transferred from one body to another. Now, when we listen to samskaras, what we understand, Sanskrit is a very tricky language. There are so many meanings to the same word. Actually, what samskaras mean, and there are many meanings to it, but what is samskara means? It's an impression of one's mind,
right,
of deeds that were performed and experienced in a former state of existence.
Right.
So these are nothing but your mental impressions or your recollections. And this is what is forming your mental memory, the faculty of the memory.
Mm.
And samskaras are nothing but, they also in this lifetime, it is your cleansing process, it's your purification process, it's your polishing process, any ceremonies that you do to purify these samskaras. Because these are already there as imprints in your mind, and that's why your moon is very important when you talk about in Jyotisha. In the Indian system, it's always seen from the moon, because moon is what which carries these vasanas.
Right.
We call it vasanas in Sanskrit. What is vasanas? This is the knowledge which is derived from our memory based on your present consciousness of your past perceptions. Many of our reactions are based on the present consciousness of our past perceptions. These are your impressions, okay, which have been there with you, remaining unconsciously in your mind, or karmic inclinations that you have in this life. When you say karmic inclinations, and why I'm saying all of this is, before we go into the Tribhagi Dasha system that I want to explain, I want people to understand what is the basis of what we're speaking.
Right.
Okay. If you know the concepts well, then you will be able to understand Jyotish much better. First of all, you know, when you say vasanas, vasanas are connected to your mind, because when we are born, we have been given a body, and the soul enters the body, and somehow we have also been given inserted a chip. It's like a memory chip And the memory chip has all the information from the previous births. So imagine a situation, Sunilee ji, and I would like to take your viewpoints on this as well. Is if in a different lifetime, we might have taken so many lifetimes. Okay, we might have been a bird, we might have been a mosquito, we might have been a fly, animal, whatever we were. We could have had millions of lifetimes. But what people today need to recognize and honor, Sunilee ji, is human birth is the most superior form of birth in this life or this planet. On this planet, there is no other birth which can be more superior. So first feel, grateful that we have got this body in a human form. Why? Is when you are an animal or you are a bird or you are any other animal creature, there is very little karma you can burn because you are always following the cosmic laws, the nature's law. You cannot go against it. If you have to suffer, you will suffer. But human birth is only birth on this planet which gives you the intellect, the buddhi, to decipher and to make changes with free will. You have the free will to change many of the things. You can better your karmas. You can burn many of your past karmas. You can realize there is awareness level which is not there in other animals. So first of all, be very grateful and don't waste this lifetime by doing things that will not benefit you. Because next life, who knows where I will be born, in which space I will be born. So if you are born with a roof and food on the table, you are much better than most people on this planet.
Right.
Nobody even recognizes this. Today, if you are sitting and having internet and we are discussing this, we are very, very fortunate. We are the very few fortunate people.
Yes.
So that means our vasanas and our samskaras somewhere have, given us this opportunity. Let us make of this opportunity to put it to good use. And that is where I want to come for this thing of Adhyatmika, Adhi Bhautika and Adhi Devika. Because this nobody talks about, but this is the genesis of everything that we suffer today. Because today what has happened in this world, it's a toxic greed which has contaminated people's mind. What is the greed? I want fame, I want name, I want money, I want every materialist comforts. But what is happening to the environment? Because of these external manifestations of the ecology of the mind is completely locked. The ecology of the mind is become toxic because of the greed and the contamination of the minds. Jyotisha is one subject I have to tell you, Sunilee ji. We cannot learn it in one lifetime.
It's a never.
Yes. It's a subject of timeless studies over multiple lifetimes.
That is why I told you we are mulas.
Exactly.
Only roots are inside depth. But we are the trees over, and we are the, I think, dry leaves only.
Correct.
Which can blow anytime. And then new leaves will come. New generation, new birth. Always, I always consider like this. That consider a tree. So old is going and new is coming. And what you said about this Traya Tapas. Nowadays.
Tapatraya.
So nowadays, Adi Bhautik is very much in motion. Everybody is after material life. I'll say
material
that.
Life.
That is Bhautik Sukh. Bhautik, we call it as Bhautik Jagat.
Correct.
So all material life nowadays, so that is more important. And then Adi Devika is becoming less, and we people are just trying to motivate people to go towards Adi Devika.
Exactly. Because it is all connected. You're right, Sunilee ji. This is Adi Devika is what Jyotish and other sciences can bring you in your life.
Yes.
Okay. Because these are unseen forces. Today we call those unseen forces which influence us as gods. But this is where I think many people are not realizing. And then Adhyatmika, which means Adhyatmika means pertaining to your Atma, your body, and which includes your mind as well. Okay. Adi Bhautika, usually what I have heard from people, from scholars, is it's that category of fear which is there within you. I told you the karmic code, the samskara, the vasanas. The fear which is there, which has arisen in your life because of enemies, animals, the sufferings that you have gone through because of some living being. Now let me give you an example. Is imagine, Sunilee ji, that in one lifetime that you might have had, in human lifetime, you might have been a caveman, hazaro saal pehle, thousands of years ago. Imagine that you had to feed a family. So you have gone hunting. You've gone hunting out, you have a family, you have a, you know, say imagine you have a wife, you have children at home, and you are a man, you want to go hunting and bring food on the table. When you go for hunting, suddenly you could hear some danger. The danger was you could hear the atmosphere suddenly become very cold. You know, the leaves start rolling. You can suddenly hear, you know, some hustling sound. You know, there is danger lurking. You don't know what is it. And suddenly you see a tiger comes out of the woods and it's staring at you. And you're just there alone. So you had probably two options then. One option was to fight the danger, or to flight, which means to run away from it. Imagine the situation where you had chosen to run away from that situation. And the tiger chased you, it hunted you down and killed you. So, or imagine another situation where you said, no, I want to fight this and I want to see. Maybe in the fight also you might have died. But you gave it a brave, you didn't run away, you didn't show your back to the problem. You challenged it, you fought it, but you died valiantly. So tell me, in this life, if you are bringing some of your prarabdha karmas from that life, what planets will be activated in your chart? Fighting the challenge will give you a strong Mars in this lifetime. Flighting away, which is running away, will give you a weak Saturn in this life.
Weak Saturn.
Because you're flighting away means you're running away. See, Saturn is about showing restraint, but at the same time, it is also to fight or flight.
Right.
But you need both. Don't get me wrong that, you know, when people say malefic planets, I don't call it malefic. They're a little bit stringent, a little bit strict. But all of them have a quality. Because if when you're sleeping, these two planets are very, very important. And this is medical science, I'm saying. I speak very generally, Sunilee ji. I'm not going to speak, because I know we'll come to the point of going to the dashas, but that I can teach even in 10 minutes. But
oh, this is very, I find this is, see, automatically we are discussing this. So maybe it's a karmic.
It's a karmic thing.
This is Adhi Deva, Adhi Daivak.
Daivika.
We are fulfilling our spiritual needs.
Spiritual needs, absolutely. Okay. At the same time, maybe after Adhi Devika, you want to go into Adhyatmika.
He's
trying to learn about these scriptures, trying to satisfy your soul. Mm. Somewhere we are all trying to satisfy our desires of a person. Mm. So anyway, let's go to this. So Saturn and Mars. So if you fought, then your Mars will come very strong, even though you died. So people who were fought in a battle and died valiantly on the battle, very powerful Mars when you will get in this life, if that is one of the prarabdha that you have. Anyway, so these, but I was saying about sleeping. When you sleep, what are two planets which work on your body? All the planets are wherever they are. But remember, the first few hours of your sleep, as soon as you sleep, Mars is very active in your body. What is Mars? Mars is the RBC, red blood corpuscles. That's why, you know, bone marrow is connected to Mars.
Mars.
At the same time, the antibodies in the body are fighting against all these
white blood cells and all that.
Yes, they're fighting. So Mars is active. And that's when your Mars is active, it said medically your eye movement is happening. It's called random eye movement. So for a long period of time, your body is just processing the information that you have got from that day's work, or that day's influences, events, even the germs that you have inhaled, whatever is there, Mars is active, Mars is fighting. Then comes a period which is called as deep sleep state. that state is when Saturn is most important. When you are in the most restful state, Saturn starts its repair work in the body. Repair work is whenever it has to, whenever you go into deep sleep. That's why it's very important how much of, it's not about how much of sleep you have, how much of deep sleep you have. Because when Saturn is active, your kidneys are being healed, repaired. The cells are being regenerated. Your pancreas are being, you know, rested and healed. So there is a repair work which is going in the body. And that repair work is all done by karma karaka shani. So do you think Saturn and Mars are bad for you?
Not at all. I never consider it bad.
Correct.
Nor any planet.
Because, exactly. So which means when can these people, any of these things can give you an influence of that? Is when either you are not sleeping very well, which means there is no repair work happening in your body. That is why illness comes, and that is why you say Saturn is karaka for illness also. That means you are not giving enough rest. You are not allowing Mars and Saturn to complete its cycle. That is why you are saying Adhi Bhautika, which means the fear of these animals, these phobias that we have had from our previous life, something will come and impact us. And that is why, from that, I want to go into this concept of the dasha system. Because everything is based on this. The dasha system itself of nakshatras is based on these concepts. Once you understand these concepts and you realize this, then you can see how beautifully the system works.
Right.
Okay. So, look at these elements to balance in your life. All that you do in the dasha is trying to balance the energies of the grahas. What are they doing on your body? What are they doing on your mind? What are they doing in your environment? They don't do anything. They are only playing out of what you are just trying to get. So let's go to the system that I want to teach about dashas. It's a very simple technique that I learned from the book by A.V. Sundaram ji. Professor A.V. Sundaram is I've considered him as my guru. When I say a guru, because he's a teacher, he's a great teacher. I might have spent very little time with him, but whatever I learned, maybe he has taught me much more than I can learn from this entire life, because he's downloaded so much of his grace, you know, just by not even teaching me. I'm like the Ekalavya.
He has jewels within him.
Exactly.
वो चलता फिरता हीरे का दुकान है.
Yes, exactly. So he has so much of knowledge, and when you just go to him with grace, he's not even taught me much, but from his books I've learned, and I've used those techniques. But this technique that has come from his book Insights in Nadi, beautiful technique, very simple. Then I started testing it. Works brilliantly when I do it with nakshatras. He has not talked about nakshatras, but he has talked about nakshatras. But when I say when I use that apply, it works brilliantly. Now I have to tell you one thing. When you go to this technique, first of all, you have to. You're okay? You're
fine. Yeah, I have got some cough cold. So in between, I get some.
Everywhere. It's
but you please, on. Yeah, this season is very bad. Season. I'm sorry to interrupt, but. You please
continue. No, don't worry. Yeah.
Actually, so I am very fortunate to learn from Shri A.V. Sundaram ji. And personally, I have been there twice, Hyderabad. And many things I learned. I didn't learn anything in syllabus. In fact, what you said.
Yes, correct.
It was random teaching.
Random.
It was random teaching.
Yes.
Nothing, no topic decided, nothing
no
like...
Topic.
We decided something else and we talked something else. But
something
that
else.
Was very yes. much beneficial, you know. Same
exactly.
way. Same way. So Insight of Nadis is the best book everybody must refer.
And also take the thing, because he has given it in subtle things, but I think you have to take the nuggets and you have to practice. Work hard on it, you will find success. And sir has never said to me, you know, read this, and but he has given me some guidance, you know, very gentle. You know, you speak for 5-10 minutes, he'll give you some inputs, he'll say
right.
try, test this, do, and then you take it up and you start researching. So that's why I'm very grateful. Anyway, let's talk about the technique. The technique is, first of all, you need to understand the system of nakshatras. Okay? There are nakshatras are divided. There are 27 nakshatras. There are 28 systems. Let's take the 27 nakshatra scheme because it's easily divisible by, you know, in groups of 9 and it can be divisible by 3. So with that, we have 3 cycles. Okay, we can divide each nakshatra, 9 nakshatras into one. So from your Janma nakshatra, the first 9 nakshatra is called as Janma nakshatras. The first 9. So Janma, Anujanma, Trijanma. Okay, this is the concept that Sundaramji said. Janma, Anujanma, Trijanma, which means Janma means that's your present. Anu Janma, which means which is coming in future. Trijanma means which is behind you. Okay. So the Trijanma part is actually showing you that the 3 phase of the wholeness of your life. Don't think that we are individual and it is my karmas, it is my whole thing. You form a complete wholeness with your ancestors, with you and your children. This is you, fifth house is your children. So, you know, the lagna or your ascendant is you, which is your present situation. Ninth house is your father or your lineage or your dharma, your ancestor, your gurus or whatever. That's your past. And then your future is the fifth house, which is your children. All these 3 actually creates a whole of you. Not one. Not just you. Because what you're talking about is only the current. But your whole life means including the past and the future. That becomes your whole life. We disregard these 2 concepts. That's the beauty of the system of nakshatra tribhagi. Tribhagi is a terminology. There is other, there's Parashara also tribhagi system, but I've called it tribhagi because it's a 3 ways of dividing. And an astrologer from Japan, who is, you know, he's very popular. His name is Viktikara. He has called it as Tribhagi Sundari.
Yeah.
Okay, he's given a name.
Sundari, I read it. So
Tribhagi Sundari, he has given the name Tribhagi Sundari Dashavichar. So we are all studying the system. We'll see how it goes. But I want to say this is your whole thing. Your past, your present, future. You cannot distinguish. And that is why your Janma, Anujanma and Trijanma are all connected. Which means nakshatras are all linked. Which means if a nakshatra is in Sun, nakshatra Kritika, then it will also have in some part of, you know, Uttara Falguni and also Uttarashada. Results will come in the Sun's Mahadasha.
Right.
Sun's Mahadasha will give you the flavor of all the 3 nakshatras. Okay.
Here age is also considered?
Age will not, I think, you know, I'll tell you what. Basically what I do, the technique is very simple. From your moon, okay, from your moon, natal moon, if you're running the dasha of Sun, let us assume your natal moon is in Ashwini nakshatra. So which is the first nakshatra of the Sun? If you're running this, you've just started your comments, your Sun Mahadasha.
Kritika.
Kritika. So for, and how long is the Sun Mahadasha? 6 years. In Vimshottari, I'm talking only specifically Vimshottari.
Yeah, Vimshottari.
So in Vimshottari Dasha, it is 6 years. So 6 years divided into 3 parts. 2 years for Kritika, 2 years for Uttara Falguni, 2 years for Uttara Shada.
Shada.
Now, the beauty of the system is you should know a little bit about nakshatras. Then you will see the first 2 years of your Sun Mahadasha will start giving you results of Kritika nakshatra. But where is the flavor different? If somebody has, you know, moon in, let us say, Dhanishta, it will give different results from moon in Ashwini. Because where would Kritika Nakshatra fall from the moon? And also, where will Kritika Nakshatra fall from your Lagana? That will give you the difference.
Right.
That is the first step. Second step is, if you make Kritika Nakshatra as the Lagana and read your entire chart for those 2 years like a normal chart. Did you understand? Do you have any questions or doubts?
Kritika Nakshatra in Lagna means?
Which means aap Kritika Nakshatra ko, which means you make Kritika. For example, that is also a secret there. Now, secret, what is it? Kritika has four padas.
That is why I asked.
Yes, four padas. So 2 years he divided into 6 months each.
6 months each.
So Kritika Nakshatra first pada will be active for first 6 months. That means you make Aries as the Lagna and then read the chart.
Right.
But also remember, the qualities of first pada of Kritika will also be giving some, depending on where that, you know, that pada will be, what is the significance of that pada, that will give you the result. Because, you know, it will go into the Sagittarius Namamsha. If you start from the system from Ashwini, it's a third nakshatra. So Sagittarius Namamsha for the first pada. Then it will be Capricorn. Then you see in the Namamsha also what planets are sitting in the Namamsha.
Yeah.
If there is planet sitting in Sagittarius, some flavor of Sagittarius, that planet will come in that dasha. Okay, of the first pada of Kritika. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So simple technique. So break the nakshatra, the Mahadasha into three parts. Then you break even that into four parts. Why? Because there are four padas. Okay. Then you make Aries as a Lagna. Then read the same chart with the same planets in your chart. Don't make any difference.
Okay.
Read how the results would be.
Here, can we also mean, I'm not very sure. If I'm born in third charan, okay, and that Surya Dasha is on. So can I directly put third charan over there?
Yes,
you can. In Lagna?
Yes.
Because already starting, two charans have gone.
Over, correct. So when you're born, if you're born in third charan, start your life with studying from third charan.
So that will be much more accurate then.
Correct. Absolutely. And Sunilee ji, I'm not saying that. This I'm saying this is a research work. So obviously, whatever ideas you're bringing on the table from your experience, I think it will add more value. So don't even hesitate to give such suggestions, because that is logical, isn't it?
If you are, because I have done this. I have done this.
Have you done it?
Yeah. Okay. And this really works very best. Particularly if we are talking about any health issues, I do sun chart. I just put the Charan Swami, whatever, means which Rashi, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. This Charan will get over, then again from Mesha it will start.
Correct.
So we can just put that particular planet related event, whatever, Rogoni or health or profession, anything. So we just have to put that Charan Swami, Lord of that Charan, as
an
ascendant.
Oh, okay. So in which Namamsha or in
as a natal chart you have to do it.
In a natal chart, not in Namamsha.
Okay. Namamsha you won't be able to differentiate it then. First you have to see here only what planets are connected to that Lagna Lord. Means Lagna Lord means Charan Swami Lord.
Charan Swami Lord, correct.
And how the Lagnesh means how that ascendant Lord is connected to that Charan Swami Lord.
Swami Lord. Beautiful.
And then see the Mahadasha. How this Mahadasha Lord is connected to all these three things.
Yes.
I do this way also. So this really gives very good. I have not done, I have not written anything on it, but I do it. I just go on.
Tell us so that you know your viewers also will benefit. Tell us the technique.
Same way what I said. So that way also you can go. Directly you can put that. another very simple way what we learned in our jyotish.
This what Sunilee ji just tell me, this you're doing with the moon and the charan swami lord of the moon, or with the ascendant charan swami lord?
No, here by two methods you can do it. First method is you can just take the mahadasha lord. Okay, you see what charan that mahadasha lord is placed in your chart, and just you put okay. that as a lagna.
Correct.
Okay. One way. Second method is, what is the person's question? So related, that significance related, if Surya is connected, so we have to see that also. Two ways you can make it possible. So this really fruits very good. Specifically, I do it for Mahadasha. I directly Mahadasha. Put that only. Charan Other than that, if you are not able to put charan wise also, because it becomes difficult. It is not so easy. Charan Swami, you have to put it in Lagna. My Charan Swami, even though I am running Mercury Dasha, Charan Swami can be Jupiter also.
Correct.
I have to keep Jupiter. Now, what Jupiter, whether it is Sagittarius or it is Pisces? If Jupiter rakke nahi chalega, then I will keep that. Along with that, I will see transit also. I will make that chart first. I will put in same chart, I will put all the planets in present transit also.
Wow. Okay.
So this will also gives you fruit like Naumansha also. You need not see another chart.
Correct. Beautiful.
You can just mix and match that. If you don't want to do this, directly just put the Mahadasha Lord as a Lagna Lord. That is very, many people are following that. Or you can just put the Nakshatra Lord as a Lagna Lord.
Lagna Lord, correct.
What Mahadasha we are running. Correct. That also you can do. This really fruits very good. Actually think what you are, you come to know by this only, Nakshatra. Nakshatras are the base of everything. Without Nakshatra, you cannot do anything.
Correct. Because otherwise you're lost, because there's so many permutation combinations. How can you say in a Mahadasha what will happen? Mahadasha has run for so many years. How are you going to deal in it? It's very difficult. So it's a beautiful technique that you're telling.
Even yours, whatever Tribhagi, whatever you are saying, this is three parts. Everything three like parts. 999. Same way. So that cycle also, like Rashi wise also, means zodiac wise also, you can see which zodiac Mahadasha you are running.
Correct.
That way also you can see.
And then if you see, Sunilee ji, with this three bhagi system, you would have covered all the 25 Navamsha zodiac signs. Because anywhere you have to cover with all the three nakshatras, means you have covered all the
108.
So 108. So you will go through this whole cycle of 108 in one Mahadasha. Okay. And also to add to that, which is again, you have also told me some techniques. Now I will go and definitely test them.
Please. And let me know.
Now there is an additional layer. See, you can add more layers as per your experience grows and your complexity. You want to be able to, you know, do many of the calculation jugglery.
Yeah.
Then what I would do is also from the Charana Swami Lord, which is, you know, the Swami of the Nakshatra Pada, I will see where does the Nakshatra Lord gets exalted, debilitated, and which is his Mula Trikona house.
Right.
That will give me additional clues for that Mahadasha. These places, then I will fine tune my results depending on, you know, if it is Saturn which is going, Mars which is going, Rahu, Ketu, or if it is, you know, you have Jupiter going there, Venus going there. You will be able to tell in the transit what could happen. Because see, the Nakshatra Lord and the Mula Trikona of the Nakshatra Lord becomes the head office. the exaltation point where it gets maximum exaltation power, that again becomes its strength, and then this is debilitation, deep debilitation point. These three I see what I call as dynamic balance. If you see in the chart, right, whichever houses these are falling in, these are the houses where maximum energies are being exchanged in that Mahadasha and in that part of the Charana Swami. Now, if I want to add more, like you said, we can make the Charana Swami Lord also see what is the influence of the Charana Swami Lord with the transits.
Yeah, that is what. Transit Kundli, we can put in that Kundli only.
Transit, that Kundli only. Transit Kundli also you put there, you will see beautiful results.
Yeah, very beautiful. That saying, is what I do.
Yeah, and then if you know Nakshatra is deep, if you know the mythology, if you know the Devata, if you know the Shakti of that Nakshatra, if you know the category of the Nakshatra, you know, whether it is Mishra Nakshatra, whether it's Tiksha Nakshatra, it's a Daruna Nakshatra, all of these, then you should be knowing whether it is, you know, what is his Mukha, which is face, whether it's facing up, facing down.
Adomukhi, Urdhvamukhi.
Okay. Adomukhi, Urdhvamukhi, Triangamukhi. Then you can see what direction that nakshatra is facing. Yes. Is it east, north, south, west? So many flavors you can add on top of it, and then you can really give some. But it needs intense energy you need to spend on trying to. If you just simply do this, you don't even need to know. I can tell you exactly what is happening. Many people will just vouch that this system, and of course the system that you are telling also we can add as a layer. There is no end to it. We can add more and more layers as long as you know how to decipher and interpret it. The challenge is in interpretation. The challenge is not in the system. How you interpret based on the Nakshatra Devata, based on the Nakshatra Shakti, based on the mythology, the legends, kya kahani hai uska, that will give you the flavor, and flavor will 100% show you.
And total base should be your Adhi Adhyatma.
Yes.
Without that, if you are in Adi Bhakti, only you know the theory. But you cannot. You know how to implement, but you don't know how to fruit it.
Yes. So that is where I am bringing the Adhyatmik part also very important. Adi Devik also you have to know what is the Devatas doing there.
Right.
What is their mythology? That is why I said Adi Bhautika is not important. Today everybody is interested in techniques, shortcut methods. This and this combination, this will happen. You tell me, for thousands of shots, how can it give you precise results? And exactly the flavor will be different, right? The flavor will be different. I'm saying results might be the same, which means imagine if somebody gets a promotion. Somebody gets a promotion, but he's also jealous that so many people have got more promotion than. Somebody gets a hike, but he has not got enough hike. But imagine somebody who has jumped from becoming, being just a senior manager in some place, suddenly has become an assistant vice president, or suddenly has gone up so quickly. Why do such jumps happen? Same combinations. That is when these techniques will come very handy to know why suddenly this guy has arisen. Was there some connection with Rohini Nakshatra? Was there some connection with Jyeshtha Nakshatra? Because you have to know Indra. Indra sits. And that is where I say this one more secret I'll tell you. When you're adding this also know the animal associated with that nakshatra. Then you will know how that nakshatra will go. The
yoni.
Theme also of that yoni, exactly. Yoni. If you know the yoni, then you will know how the dasha will also go. How will you feel in that dasha? The same energies of the yoni will come into the dasha's flavor. Imagine if it is like a serpent, then you will be low, you'll be creeping, you'll be crawling, you'll be doing energy, but fast also it might be fast, but there might be some manipulation. There might be some, you know, venom. Okay, there might be some, you know, enchanting, you know, some relationships, some romanticism, maybe there's sensuality which might break up or something. I'm just saying generally, know the traits of the animals. Imagine if you're sitting on an elephant. If it is, what is the elephant connected to? It is connected to Revati Nakshatra or Bharani Nakshatra. Immediately when the planet is transiting in that Nakshatra, you'll almost feel like you're sitting on an
elephant. Airavat.
Or think of Airavat or think Jyeshtha Nakshatra. Jyeshtha Nakshatra connected to Indra, which means any planet will come there, na? They will never see below. They will never be
there. Airavat will come for
Jyeshtha. Airavat will
right.
come. So bring the mythology wherever it is, bring the, you know, the significance of the yoni and see how beautifully this system.
This is beautiful.
Don't use, yeah, look at the yoni. If it is a deer type, then some of the results will come very quickly in your mind. Some, if it is very slow, then they'll bring the flavors, but they'll bring it in a different style to you.
That is why for matchmaking we see yonis.
Yonis.
They should match with each other, otherwise their personal right. physical life will get disturbed.
Correct. Although there are some points given to it, 30 out of 36 points in Ashtakuta.
We should never rely on that.
Never. Yes.
I
don't do anyway
matchmaking.
I can't understand also. I don't know the technique anyway. It doesn't matter. But what I'm saying is Nakshatra Yonis have a different meaning. If you go yeah. very deep into it, you will find every characteristics of the native somewhere connected to the yoni also. I'm not saying only. So what are the secrets? Bring the nakshatra devata, you know, bring the mythology, you know, bring the planet, the karakatva of the planet also, the madasha. That also gives you the flavor, definitely. So I'm saying bring all the basic principles of Jyotish. Don't have to complicate life. Make
right.
it simple. Learn one technique or learn one concept, learn principle. Stick to it for next 2-3 years. Stick to it. Master it. That is what I do not understand Jyotish as people do. I know. I can say I'm not even an astrologer. I don't. I have very, very little knowledge. I'm only learning the basics. Maybe I'll learn basics till my death also. But I will say all the secret lies in the basics, not in complex things. The more complexity you add, then you're making your life difficult to analyze. Because what to use? You might have learned 1,000 techniques.
It's of no use.
10,000 techniques you can't apply on a chart. Maximum you'll apply the techniques is maybe 3 or 4 maximum. I'm saying when you're reaching a kundi for half an hour, 45 minutes or 1 hour, how much ever you try, 5-6 techniques at the most you will try. What is the point in learning that? Instead of that, I say learn one technique, practice it 10,000 charts. That is where the technique will grow on you. Any technique, doesn't matter, any system, have faith in that system. No system is bad. Every system, because Jyotish can be made because it's multidimensional. Okay? Any system you use it, it will show you the same result. There is no difference.
I always say whatever method you use for the predictions, only thing, the fruit should be matched to the life pattern of the native.
Native.
Perfect. Whatever you do.
100%.
Because
yes.
see, as I and you know the astrology, that is why we are discussing the methods, correct. Techniques. But the third person who are coming to us, they are not interested. You are having this Raj Yoga, only Raj Yoga
yeah.
they know. Or you are having this combination. They want the result. They want the fruit. That's it. They are not going to ask you that. Many people are there who do ask. But routinely when they come personally to us, they are least interested in all these things, you know. They want the fruit. They want the result.
They want result.
And here our honesty and our dedication works a lot. And our, in Hindi we say, Adhyatma ki baithak lagti hai.
Yes. Yes.
Your spiritual element you have to awaken.
And
that is very much necessary.
Yes. And many a times it's your intuition also which gets developed after reading. And sometimes you can't explain to people how you do certain readings.
Yeah.
And that comes only through practice. Practice
right.
on, you know, at least 100, 200 charts. Then you talk about something about technique. Without practicing it on 200 charts, you are going and making comments on Facebook saying this technique works. You tested it on 2 charts. You tested it in your chart. You tested it on somebody else's chart. 2 or 3 charts maximum. Then you will make a passer comment saying that this technique. Hare Baba, how can you even know whether that technique works or not? Every technique I've seen works. Every technique, I'm telling you. It is as to have faith in any technique or any system. But remember, techniques can be many. But the principles, if you learn, that is for life, which is the concept, the basic, the underlying concept, which is, I'm saying, grahas, rashis, nakshatras, you know, bhavas. These concepts you try to master. Don't run behind from one technique to another, one dikta to another. Basics, if you do, you are completely sorted for
your. So everybody must read Laghu Parashari every day.
Yes, 100%. It's a short. Laghu means short. Can you imagine such short Parashari? You know, it has got only a few slokas in it. And if you read, you can get lost with it for a lifetime reading even those and trying to interpret that. How many of them are today reading classics?
Okay. No, very few are reading.
Yes. And forget reading classics. Sometimes I can sit with them reading one, sloka or one classic or one book, any book. Usually how I study, Sunilee, I don't have the time. Everybody is busy today. Nobody is. I just take one book. Okay, I put it on my forehead. This is what A.V. Sundaram said. Put it on my forehead, meditate on it, okay, and then say, please give me guidance. And then I open any page of the book. Then my eyesight will fall on some sloka, some dikta there. Then I will sit and think about it.
That is for you, that dikta.
Yes, it is for
you. You always say that.
Yes.
Whatever page it will come.
Yeah, same thing you can do with Bhagavad Gita. I am telling you, but your desire of that question should be so potent that you want to have a real. Don't do it, today I'm feeling stomachache, let me go to the Bhagavad Gita and ask. No. Unless your desire and that question is so important, do the same with Bhagavad Gita, and whatever your eyesight falls on the sloka of the Bhagavad Gita, 110% it will give you some great meaning. But read it not once, read it at least 5, 6, 10 times. Even 20 times you read that sloka over and over again, over and over again. Then you will get some meaning, some hidden meaning is there.
Yeah, Sundaram sir told me the same thing, that just open the Bhagavad Gita, any page it will get open. That sloka is for you, or if you are reading for somebody else, yes. Whoever comes to you, if you want the spiritual answer of that.
Spiritual answer.
So just, and that is really matching.
It's second really thing, matching, and I've said 100%.
Second thing, Saundarya Lahari. That you have to open and you just have to read the shloka. That is very effective.
Yeah.
And third thing, any book in front of you, just open it.
Any book, exactly.
See the number.
See the number there on the page number. And calculate it by 27. I use that nakshatra also.
Yeah, I do the same. I do the same.
When you are in a rush, you don't have the time to do even. So use this technique. I use this technique everywhere. It works for me. Imagine you are traveling. You don't have a software or anything. Today, you have Cosmic Insight, which is giving you that on the move. You can also, have this app. But I'm saying, imagine if you don't want to use any apps, you're not tech savvy, use the book that you have. Everything is a divination science. Everything in this world is completely connected with numbers, stars. Everything is one system. Whether you talk about vastu, the space, whether you talk about numbers, numerology, everything is connected. It's a beautiful thing. Our universe is such a beautifully aligned. The only misfit are human beings on this planet. All are fits on this planet. All animals, birds, plants, they're all a fit because they know where they are. Only we are a misfit on this planet, unfortunately, because we are after this greed mentality, this toxic greed mentality I was talking about.
Because we have to fulfill the karmic cycle. That is why we are on this earth. And these karmic connections are from human to human. From human to animal. Also,
human to birds.
That is why we keep pets in our house.
Right. Everything is connected.
Yeah. Everything is connected. And I always consider human birth is the... sometimes I always think that animal yoni is good. At least they cannot speak. They cannot tell you, I want this, that. you know, sometimes I feel also nice. We are human being. At least we can feel the things. Panchendriya. Yes. We are able to use it.
And we can, you can also be able to change the situation based on our feelings.
Yeah, but only thing, yeah, we have to capture our shadaripus.
Shadaripus.
That is very difficult.
Kama
krodha madha moha matsara.
Kama krodha lobha moha madha matsara.
This is very difficult. Speaking is very easy. One or two at least you can really overcome. One or two definitely you can do. Krodh you can control. Moha also you can control.
Attachments. Moha
Kaam after certain age you can control. We have to be very practical. Now what you told, I will just add on to it. You told about Tapatriya, right? Right?
Tapatriya. Miseries.
I consider all the saints like Sri Ramakrishna Paramhans, you know, they pass from all these three things, Tapatriya.
Yes, yes.
From material to Adhyatma and from Adhyatma to Daivik.
Daivik, correct. Absolutely.
He is the perfect example and then Swami Vivekananda. But Swami Vivekananda was very much less into material, bhautika. From initial stage only, he was more into Adhyatmika.
Adhyatmika and then Daivik as well.
Then Daivik. But Ramakrishna Paramhans, he was in all these three stages.
All these three stages. Absolutely.
Many saints like him. We don't know much about everybody, but for him at least, we can say that this is really matching. So, this was very wonderful and really wonderful. I don't have any words for it because this is needed. This was to be, I think this was planned by nature to be discussed, you know. Because we didn't discuss any UTs or any combinations or houses and all that. But whatever we discussed is something our soul will grasp, our soul will inhale. So I hope that everybody viewing this and view in future also will be inhaling the spiritual element out of this video. And may we all be blessed really with the Adi Adhyatmik and then Adi Daivik. Because already we are into Adi Bhautik.
Adi Bhautik.
So no blessing of Adi Bhautik more. Already we are into it.
True.
So next two we have to just surrender ourselves. So definitely we can go ahead. Thank you very much for just accepting my request also. And it was nice. We are waiting for your book.
Yes.
When it is going to come, you said in February.
It should be in a few weeks. It should be out by end of January or February. So, you know, there's more work yet to be done. But I think the book will be out. So
I wish you all the best for that book also. That time I will meet you personally when your book arrives. And really, it was very nice. God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you, Sunilee. Appreciate it.
Yeah.